To go be more introvert, to go more deep into our heart in a relationship with Krishna and Guru and the Vaishnavas, and try to read more scriptures and chant more and pray. Just few days back, one devotee forwarded me a message of Srila Prabhupada, where somebody was asking Prabhupada about World War III and disasters of the world, what should we do? And Srila Prabhupada said, don't worry. You do whatever is possible on the material platform, but you should know that everything is happening by the will of Krishna. And you just hear and chant and prepare to go back to Godhead. Now we have to take, like many senior disciples of Prabhupada also in the current situation have encouraged us, that we should take whatever precautions, whatever medical help, but ultimately take shelter of Krishna. One disciple of Srila Jayapatak Swami Maharaj wrote to him recently that I am very depressed seeing the situation, and it appears that some people are purposefully spreading this kind of thing. Srila Jayapatak Maharaj wrote that, what can you expect? Kaler Doshe Nidhi Rajan. This is expected in Kali Yuga. There will be the situation. But you concentrate on the second part. Astire Eku Mahan Gunad. One great quality. Kirtana Deva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Paramrija. Just by chanting the holy name, one can get liberated. So yes. Maharaj was emphasizing, don't take shelter of the social media, take shelter of Krishna. So, for me also, it's a great blessing. I am grateful to the temple authorities and all the devotees for allowing me to stay here and get purified. Once again, seeing the blessings of, especially Mataji's blessings, I can speak something in today's verse. I'm a small child in front of exalted devotees. In today's verse, we are reading this story of King Ayati. It's a very instructive story explaining the nature of this material world, how sense gratification can never satisfy someone. In the Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada gives example in the purport, like putting ghee in the fire. No matter how much ghee you put, it is not going to extinguish the fire. So sense gratification by nature is like this. Prabhupada is explaining here that something about the nature of attraction between man and woman. Prabhupada writes here that just like this example of the he-goat, she-goat, a man is looking for sense gratification and woman also needs protection. So, there is a bona fide ashram, the grihastha ashram, which Prabhupada is indicating that woman should be under the care of the father before marriage, husband after marriage, and in case the husband leaves or takes sannyas, then the son should take care. So this kind of actually protection for women is very scientific. Sometimes in the name of women's liberation, Prabhupada would explain that actually what happens is that when they are not taken care of properly, either by the husband or by the society of elderly personalities, then it results in exploitation. So in Vedic culture, actually woman is given a very special position of respect. It is seen that it's not a man or woman seen as a Vaishnavi, and with great respect, like the word Mataji is used for a woman, that means mother. So Prabhupada explained Chanakya Pandit that a person should see every woman as mother, except for one's lawfully wedded wife. Matravat paradareshu, loshtavat paradravyeshu, matravat paradareshu. That means another's wife you see as mother. It means with respect. And another's wealth one sees as garbage, one doesn't try to possess. And atmavat sarvabhuteshu, means you see every living being as you would like yourself to be treated. In the Bible there is a saying that do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So, a devotee should treat everyone with great respect, amanina manadena, and be very careful not even to give any anxiety to any living being. what to speak of physical harm. Like we see in the story of Mrigarari, the hunter. Mrigarari was a very cruel hunter. He was torturing the animals. And not only, he would not even kill the animals, but he would delight in the suffering of the animals. So he would shoot arrows in such a way that the animal would be half killed. And when he would see the animal crying in pain, then he would take great pleasure. Srila Prabhupada also explains in one lecture about some kind of butcher who take pleasure in the animals being suffering. So Mrigari was so fortunate in Prayag, he met Srila Narada Muni. We see that whenever one comes into contact with a great personality, it is always auspicious. Even if the person who is coming into contact with the devotee may not be actually doing it for the purpose of spiritual enlightenment or spiritual progress, but somehow or other, if one meets a devotee, then he will make progress. You know, sadhu sanga, sarva shastra kai, lava matra sadhu sanga sarva siddhi hai. Even a moment's association with a pure devotee can bring one to the highest perfection of life. And sometimes the results may not manifest immediately. In my own life, I was fortunate to be born in Mumbai and it was very close to the Radha Ras Bihari temple in Juhu. So I was not so much of a, you know, spiritual person. But somehow or other, some devotee gave me Back to Godhead magazine, and it was during the last year of Prabhupada's Manifest Leela in 1977. So Prabhupada had some programs in March, big Pandal programs, and devotees encouraged me also. So I was just 12, 13 years old. I hardly could understand what Srila Prabhupada was saying, except that I remembered that prasad was very good. There was pineapple halwa and puri sabji. At that time, I could relish those things. Now my body doesn't allow. So I did not really understand or even take to chanting. I was chanting few rounds. And of course, after a few months, Prabhupada left. But later, when I went to America for higher studies, and I was fortunate, one of the devotees allowed me to stay in the temple and attend the programs. And then I became serious and I joined in 1987. So then I could realize that I met Prabhupada in 1977. So the result, the association with the devotee, even though the result may not manifest immediately, the effect is there. Like in the case of Mrigari, he was a cruel hunter. And on the advice of Narada Muni, he gave up hunting. In fact, he was so cruel, he could not think of anything else. That was his profession. When Narada Muni, he told Narada Muni, I want to give you something. So Narada Muni said, you give up this hunting and just depend on Krishna. Krishna will take care. So this cruel hunter became such a great devotee. And we know the story of how when he saw Narada Muni coming and he wanted to offer obeisances to Narada Muni, and he was so careful that he would not want to hurt even an ant. He saw some ants on the way, so he moved them aside and then offered his obeisances. So this principle of being very sensitive to others is very important. I think one devotee was telling me this story of one very fortunate devotee, Peter Burwash, not formally initiated as such, but he was fortunate to get very intimate mercy from Srila Prabhupada. And he was playing a tennis game. And at that time, you know, he was at the last point of the game where if he could just win that point, he would earn a lot of money, millions of dollars. But then the place where he had supposed to be there, right at the last minute, he shifted to another place. Just nobody knew what's the reason. And then when the game began, he was at the other person serves and he had to answer the ball. And because he was at the wrong point, he lost the point, he lost the set, he lost the game, he lost the match, and he lost millions of dollars. So everybody was asking, what is the reason? He didn't tell to others, but he told the devotees that where I was supposed to stand, there were some ants. And if I were to stand there, I would probably kill the ants. And I knew Prabhupada would be displeased. So even though I lost a lot of money, but I pleased Prabhupada by being so careful. So this particular uh, this feeling that to see the presence of Paramatma in the heart of every living being, that is a sign of an advanced devotee. That a pure devotee, he likes to honor everyone. Like one devotee asked Srila Prabhupada, can we offer respects to Lord Shiva? So Prabhupada became very grave. He said, Lord Shiva? What to speak of Lord Shiva? You should offer respects even to an ant. You know? So I know for myself, you know, so many times we do offer respects to senior devotees, to Prabhupada disciples and sannyasis, as a matter of etiquette. And sometimes we are a little careless or neglectful in offering respects to those who are junior to us or those who are not so much into advanced in devotional service. But ideally, the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's principle is amanina manadena. That applies to every living being. Because the respect we are offering is to the Paramatma within the heart of every living being. According to the Shastras, the most advanced devotee is one who sees the super soul in the heart of every living being. He doesn't see any differentiation. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavi hastin shuni chaiva shapake cha pandita samadarshina. He sees that all living beings are part and parcel of Krishna, and Krishna is sitting in their heart as the super soul. So let me be very respectful. Let me be very very kind. Like Lord Jesus Christ, just a couple of days back, the day of Good Friday, and the day we know, you know, Lord Jesus Christ, Prabhupada would give the example of Lord Jesus Christ for tolerance. He would say that Haridas Thakur and Lord Jesus Christ, examples of tolerance. He knew that if he preached the message as he was guided by the Lord, he would probably be crucified. He knew that. But still he wanted to do the will of the Lord. And even when he was being mistreated, tortured, and they attempted to kill, but he was just taking it as the will of the Lord. Forgive them, for they know not. He was willing to forgive even those who were about to kill him. And same with Haridas Thakur also. Haridas Thakur was so sensitive. You know, what was the fault of Haridas Thakur? He was just chanting Hare Krishna. He did not do any crime. But because the ruler at that time, the Muslim government, they did not approve. And he was told that you should stop this chanting, otherwise you will be punished in 22 marketplaces. But Haridas Thakur was determined. He said, Khanda khanda hai deha, jadi jai pran, tabu na chadi bo harina. Even if you cut my body to hundreds of pieces, with every piece I will go on chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And when the Lord, because the Lord is very sensitive to His devotees, the Lord cannot tolerate His devotee being mistreated. The Lord sent His chakra from Vaikuntha to protect Haridas Thakur. And this Haridas Thakur simply told the chakra to go back. And a person like me, a neophyte devotee, suppose I am being mistreated and the police comes to help me, or then I will immediately say, oh, here is the person, put him in jail or punish him. But Haridas Thakur said, I can tolerate my own suffering, but I cannot tolerate that those who are killing me, they should not be suffering. This is an extreme example of tolerance which is unparalleled in human history. Prabhupada writes in one of the purports in the Bhagavatam that one can know the greatness of a person by his ability to tolerate provoking situations. Not only Haridas Thakur not only tolerated physically, we find even verbally many times he was abused, but he did not protest. Later, when the Lord saw that Haridas Thakur was being beaten, Lord covered Haridas Thakur's body with His own body. So all the beatings which were being inflicted upon Haridas Thakur, all the beatings they Haridas Thakur, which were being given to Haridas Thakur, the Lord took it on his own back. And many, many years later, in the Mahaprakash Leela, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was fulfilling Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was fulfilling every devotee's desire, and he told Haridas Thakur that I could not tolerate your suffering, so I covered your body with my body. And Lord took out his clothes, he showed the marks. This shows how much intensity is there between the relationship of the Lord and his devotee. As Lord Narayan is speaking in the Bhagavatam in the 9th canto, to in the story of Ambarish Maharaj and Durvasa Muni, the Lord is explaining to Durvasa Muni that Ahami Bhakta Paradhino, I am subordinate to my devotees. By their service attitude, they have captured me. So many times Lord Chaitanya spoke about Vasudev Datta, that I am the property of Vasudev Datta. He can sell me anywhere he likes. I am his man. Can you imagine the Supreme Lord with the controller of all controllers, Lakshmi Sahastashata Sambramano, he is served by so many Lakshmis, and he wants to become the servant of Vasudev Datta Thakur. Or for a pure devotee who is surrendered his life for serving the Lord, for preaching the glories of the Lord. So, Haridas Thakur tolerated all this. And then later on, when he was being beaten and he was just smiling, he was just chanting the name of Krishna. And finally the offenders, they became very tired and they looked very dejected. So Haridas Thakur asked what happened. So they said that if you do not die, the Nawab will punish us because we have not done our duties properly. Haridas Thakur said, oh, my being alive is a threat to you, so I will die immediately. And he just went into a state of samadhi. He closed his eyes and there was no pulse. It appeared he was dead. He had not died, but it appeared. So they took his body, actually he was there. And they decided that we will throw him in the Ganga. And after some time, of course, Haridas Thakur came out happily chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Just last night, one devotee sent me a message that, he's my younger god brother. So he said, I'm very perplexed. What is going to happen to the world, you know? So I was just replying to him and replying to myself that certainly whatever disaster we are seeing in the world is a fearful situation. But we can take inspiration from the life of Haridas Thakur, life of great personalities who were never disturbed in all calamities. Because they know that Krishna is in control. Krishna is in control. Krishna is the cause of all causes. And in all situations, Narayana para sarve na kutashana bibhyati swarga pavarga narakeshu api tulyarth darshana. That one who is a devotee of Lord Narayana or Lord Krishna, he sees equally heaven, hell or liberation, because he can remember Krishna. Wherever we can remember Krishna more, that is the best situation. Like in the Chaitanya Bhagavat, there's a story of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking to his mother Shashi Devi. Lord Chaitanya had just returned from Gaya, where he got initiated by Ishwara Puri. Actually, before initiation, Lord Chaitanya did not manifest any symptoms of ecstasy. He was just a proud, arrogant scholar. Sometimes the devotees would call him, oh, crest jewel of arrogance. That same person who later on will become teaching Trinadapi Sunichena, he was called crest jewel of arrogance. He was so proud. He would just challenge devotees to a debate and devotees would run away knowing that he is wasting time. And sometimes one devotee just ran away. So Lord Chaitanya asked his friend, why did he run away? So he said, he must have forgotten some, he may have some work, some service. Oh no, why he ran away? Because he wants to hear Krishna Katha. And I'm talking logic and grammar. But someday I will become a great devotee, that Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, they will also come to take association from me. So Lord Chaitanya, he showed this transformation after he went to Gaya, when he got initiated. He wanted to show the importance of accepting a bona fide spiritual master, that without taking a shelter of the bona fide spiritual master, one cannot develop love for Krishna. In this case, he is swam Krishna. Like once devotee asked, Srila Prabhupada was taking some interviews for initiation. Can you imagine Prabhupada personally asking questions? So Prabhupada asked this question, who is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? And the devotee said, he is incarnation of Krishna. So Prabhupada said, no, he is not incarnation of Krishna, he is Swayam Krishna. He is the Supreme Lord Himself. He is Avatari, not Avatar. You know? So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he returned from Gaya, he was just, Krishna, Krishna Kotha Gela, where is Krishna, where is Krishna? And he came to one place called Kanai Natshala. It's a very beautiful place. If those of you have been there, know. If you have not been, please plan after lockdown is over. This place is so beautiful. It's just on the side of the Ganga. And the place where the ISKCON temple is built, in the rooms, from the balcony, you feel you are inside the Ganga. It is so beautiful and purifying experience. So at Kanai Natshala, Kanai Natashala means drama. Many dramas would take place about Krishna, that's why the name came. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came there, he was just remembering Krishna in ecstasy. And there, according to the Chaitanya Bhagavat, this was the only time he actually saw Krishna. He saw Krishna and he ran after Krishna, but Krishna disappeared. So all throughout, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was always in the mood of separation. Because Prabhupada explains that the mood of separation is higher than the mood of meeting. So Mahaprabhu came to teach this mood of separation. But after he came back from Gaya to Navadvip, he told all the students, actually they were asking some questions about grammar, dhatu. The dhatu means root. What is the verbal root? So he replied, the root of all roots is Krishna. Then somebody asked him question about varnashram. Lord Chaitanya said, Lord Narayan is the root of all varnas and ashram. So the devotees were surprised. And then after 6 hours, he came back to external consciousness and he asked, how was the class? Everybody said, you did not speak anything else except Krishna. So Lord Chaitanya said, please go to some other teacher. Sorry, I am closing my books. This Nimai coaching class is stopping. You go and join some other teacher. And the student said, we don't want to go to any other teacher. Even if Lord Brahma comes, we don't want to study, we want to study from you. So from there onwards, he started preaching the glories of the holy name. In the evening, he came back to his mother and the mother asked, Shachi Devi asked, what did you teach? Then he said, I taught about the glories of the holy name, Satya Krishna Nam. The only truth in this entire material world is the holy name of Krishna. As Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Nama bina kichu nahi ko ara, Choda Bhuvana Maji. In the entire 14 worlds, from Swargaloka, Janaloka, down to Patala Loka, the only truth is the name of Krishna. So then he told his mother this reference, which I was planning to use it as an example of remembrance of Krishna. He said, when the child is in the womb of the mother, after a few months when he gains consciousness, he feels the intensity of the pain. He's surrounded, you know, by worms biting him. There is blood, stool, urine. I mean, that is a different kind of lockdown. 9 months we are all in lockdown when we are in the mother's womb. Present situation is much pleasant compared to that. So in that painful situation, he prays to Krishna, Krishna, please take me out of this situation. And then there is a sentence in the Chaitanya Bhagavat which says that the child says, if I can remember you more, then please keep me in this situation. So, in other words, a devotee always prays that, let me just remember you and let me never forget you. The conclusion of all shastras, smartavyam satatam Vishnu. If by disease or by poverty or by sickness I can remember you, then please give me more poverty and sickness and disease. Or if by wealth and good health I can remember you better, give me good health and wealth and whatever is good for me. I remember one letter which Srila Prabhupada wrote to Devananda Prabhu. Prabhupada wrote in the letter, you should pray to Krishna, very sincere prayer. My dear Krishna, you are sitting in my heart as Paramatma. From you comes remembrance and forgetfulness. Please let me always remember you and never forget you. And then Prabhupada writes in the letter that we should pray to Krishna that even if you throw me into hell, it does not matter, but just give me an opportunity to remember you. That is why the great devotees in the Mahaprakash Leela of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya is fulfilling everyone's desire, whatever they want. And the great devotees, they are simply praying for association of devotees. Because in the association of devotees, it becomes easier to remember Krishna. Satatam machita madgata prana bodhayanta parasparam. You know, coming together, maybe directly, physically, with social distancing. And if not physically, at least through internet. I've seen many devotees all over the world. Some of them are having more katha now. Maybe not physically together, but through the media of internet, devotees are giving more time for direct hearing and discussing Bhagavat and Gaur Katha and Bhagavad Gita. So, in other words, bhakti is ahetuki apratihata. No material situation can stop the progress of a devotee. In whatever situation one is, one can remember Krishna. So I was telling this point about Haridas Thakur. When he was being beaten in 22 marketplaces, he was simply remembering Krishna. And then finally, when he was thrown in the Ganga, they thought he is dead. But after some time, he came back to external consciousness. And the Nawab, although he was a very cruel person, he also had some good feelings in his heart, because he ran to Haridas Thakur. He begged forgiveness from him. He said, Haridas, you know, I used to read in the Muslim scriptures, in the Quran, there is some persons called Peer. Peer means like what we say, Mahatma or a Sannyasi, you know, exalted persons. What I was reading in the Shastras, I am seeing in you. You are a Peer. Please forgive my offense, Haridas Thakur. I was the one who ordered you to be beaten in 22 marketplaces. And what was Haridas Thakur's reply? He simply said, no, this is the will of the Lord. Not a blade of grass moves without the will of the Lord. If one can just remember this, be happy in all situations. Somebody gave me a gulab jamun today, that is the will of the Lord. Somebody stole my gulab jamun, that is the will of the Lord. Whatever happens is the will of the Lord. Somebody glorified me, the will of the Lord. Somebody chastised me without reason, the will of the Lord. Because it's not so easy to practice. Now I'll just mention one beautiful purport by Prabhupada. In the 17th chapter of the Adilila, there is a small seminar on the holy name given by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Just about 8 to 10 verses. He's just returned from Gaya and is talking to his friends in the home of Shuklambar Brahmachari. As you know, Shuklambar Brahmachari was very renounced. He had simple clothes and he had a shoulder bag. And he would just go from door to door and beg alms. And what will people give beggars? You know, just some broken pieces of rice, something which is not so valuable. And Lord Chaitanya would run after Shuklambar, Shuklambar, and he would put his hand inside the bag of Shuklambar Brahmachari and eat this raw rice. The Lord is showing that I am Bhavagrahi. I see the devotion of my devotee, not the physical offering. We see in Ramayana, Shabari, she was like tribal woman, you know, in the jungle, not very, very rich. But she was offering Lord Ramachandra some fruits. And the way she was offering is, you know, just half tasting them and then giving, if they are sweet, she would give. The Lord was accepting. So this shows that the Lord is more interested in the feelings. So Lord Chaitanya called everybody in the home of Shuklambar Brahmachari and he spoke on this famous verse, Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Harer Nama Eva Kevalam. He said this is the most important verse. And then he explained that why this Nastieva, Nastieva, Nastieva is there three times. Because not by Jnana, not by Yoga, and not by Tapasya one can know the Supreme Lord, but simply by chanting the holy name. And there's a very beautiful purport which I would like to highlight. Prabhupada says in the purport, when we tell the jnanis and the yogis that about this verse, they say, Swamiji, you are okay, we are also okay. In other words, your teaching is also good, my teaching is also good. You are chanting, that is good, I am doing yoga, that is good. So Prabhupada replied, then we simply answer that we are okay, you are not okay. Now it may seem like pride, you know, how Prabhupada is saying. But Prabhupada, just like somebody is selling pure gold, he can correct the person who is selling imitation gold. The person selling imitation gold will say, this is also gold, that is also gold. You buy whatever is your budget. But the person with real gold, he can say, this is imitation and this is real. So Prabhupada writes in the following purports, discusses this point about Trinadapi Sunichena. Lord Chaitanya tells his followers that one should become humble like a blade of grass, more tolerant than a tree. And then in the tree example, Lord Chaitanya says two points. He says, the one quality of the tree is it tolerates the heat and the rains and gives shelter to others. In the Bhagavatam also, Krishna is glorifying the trees. The trees have this quality that they give the best thing they have for the service of others. Similarly, a devotee should think, whatever Krishna has given me, that is wealth or ability to speak or ability to manage or ability to do any service, let me offer it in the service of Guru and Vaishnavas. Because nothing is actually mine. By offering it to Krishna, it is the perfection. So, Tarusama Vaishnavata, Tarusama Sahishnuta, Vaishnava Karibe, Bharstana Tadana Kake Kishuna Bolibe. That means another quality of the tree is, even when the tree is being cut, sometimes, you know, see, very thick trees, it takes them several days to cut. And while the tree is being cut, the tree is giving the shade and the fruits to the person who is killing him. The tree will give, when the person cutting becomes tired, he sleeps under the tree gives the best of the fruits to the person who is killing him, you know. It's like Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur would say that we should desire the highest good for our worst enemy. So, because this is a very high platform. Then the next verse, Prabhupada gives the purport. Prabhupada says, this quality of tolerance is very difficult to achieve. However, if one chants Hare Krishna regularly, all the good qualities will become manifest automatically. In other words, one doesn't have to externally make any separate endeavor. Just by following the process of sadhana bhakti, coming together with devotees, hearing the message of Bhagavatam and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, automatically these qualities will develop. So one should be begging Krishna, and not Krishna directly, but through the spiritual masters and through the devotees, that please give me the necessary qualification for chanting the holy name. One more instance of Haridas Thakur's tolerance comes when somebody told him that Haridas Thakur was speaking about the glories of the holy name, and there was some discussion in the home of Raghunath Das Goswami. So one person said, by a holy name you can get liberation. Another person said, by holy name you can get some other benefits. So Haridas Thakur said, this is not the real result of chanting. The real result of chanting is development of pure love for Krishna. Then he quoted from different shastras, but this, I think, was Gopal Chakravarti. He was so envious. He said, what you are speaking is nonsense. He chastised Haridas Thakur. He said, I will cut off your nose and ear. I mean, it's so insulting when in an assembly of scholars such words are spoken. And Raghunath Das Goswami's father, who was hosting the meeting, he immediately took out Gopal Chakravarti, threw him out of the room. And then he came and apologized to Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur said, I don't take it as an offense. It is just that he is ignorant. He doesn't know about the glories of the holy name. But there are three levels of devotee. One devotee is, when he is offended, suppose some harsh words are spoken, or he immediately will retaliate, you know. If somebody just hits me one, I give four with interest, you know, punishment. That is the lowest level of devotee. Second person is one who hears that he is blasphemed or mistreated and he feels bad but tolerates, because he knows that I should not react. But third level, like Haridas Thakur, he did not feel bad. He just saw it, oh, this is Krishna's mercy. He just did not get disturbed. This is dhira, that means in happiness, distress, in honor, dishonor, just to see everything equally. So these examples are there for us to, we cannot imitate, of course, we can just beg the mercy of Haridas Thakur and take shelter of the holy name. And Prabhupada writes in the conclusion to this verse that as one goes on advancing in age, after a certain age like 50, gradually one should prepare for giving up all worldly responsibilities and ultimately take sannyas and dedicate to the service of the Lord. For that practical matter, even if one may or may not take physical sannyas, but everybody can fully engage in the service of the Lord. Real sannyas means that Mukunda is one who gives liberation. That the verse which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sang when he took sannyas was that now I am engaged in the service of Lord Mukunda. So dedicate every word, every thought, and every word, every thought, and every act for the service of the Lord. That is real sannyas. Just yesterday I was discussing this, the discussion between Lord Chaitanya and the Qazi. The Qazi was saying that you are saying that we should not kill cows, but then even in the Vedic literature, sometimes there is Gomedha Yagya, Ashwamedha Yagya. So Chaitanya immediately said that in Kali Yuga this is forbidden, Gomedha, Ashwamedha, even taking sannyas. But then why did Lord Chaitanya take sannyas? Specifically for delivering the fallen souls. So, in fact, if you see the sannyas leela, our Vrindavan Chandra Maharaj was speaking some good points that how Lord Chaitanya's mood of compassion is coming out in this sannyas leela. Lord Chaitanya had a very chaste wife. There was no quarrel as such, you know. And he had nobody else, no male member at home, no children. His wife was there, and the mother is a widow, elderly woman, need care. But still Lord Chaitanya took sannyas. He was showing the importance of making the mission of the Lord as a priority over and above all obligations. Yeah. The Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, even when he reached, actually the ghat, the place where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu entered the Ganga, crossed the Ganga and went to Katwa in the middle of the night, that ghat is called Nirdai ghat. Recently I was in Mayapur for Gaur Purnima. One devotee took me to that place that's called Nirdai ghat. That ghat is called Nirdai because he did not show any mercy. He did not prevent Lord Chaitanya from going to the other side. So after Lord Chaitanya went there, even Keshav Bharati is a very exalted person. He knew Lord Chaitanya, Supreme Personality of Godhead. So how can one accept the Supreme Lord as a disciple? So Lord Chaitanya went to Keshav Bharati and spoke the mantra in his ear, that this is the mantra. And Keshav Bharati said, yes, this is the correct mantra. Now I will give you the mantra. So actually Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu initiated Keshav Bharati. And Keshav Bharati then gave the same mantra. And then when it came to the name, like generally a sannyas is given a new name. Sometimes when the sannyas guru has a particular title, the disciple also may get that title. But King Keshav Bharati was thinking, what name should I give? And then he thought he will make the whole world conscious of Krishna. So he gave the name Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya. And after receiving this name, all the devotees, there was one devotee, his name was Gangadas Bhattacharya. He just became so, he was absorbed, so immersed in the thought of Chaitanya, that he was simply chanting Chaitanya, Chaitanya, Chaitanya. And devotees gave him the name Chaitanya Das. The same Chaitanya Das who later on became the father of Srinivas Acharya. So this sannyas of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is like an inspiration, that whether physically from the external point of view one may be in water, varna or ashram, but the principle should be there of dedicating everything for the service of the Lord. And if you see what the duties of sannyas which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to Raghunath Das Goswami, it is not so much formalities, it is a question of consciousness. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Raghunath Das Goswami, when he asked what are the duties of sannyas, Lord Chaitanya said, bhalana khaiba, bhalana pariba. Do not eat very luxuriant food, or do not dress yourself very luxuriantly. That these principles can be followed wherever one is, in whatever ashram. And then specially he told this verse, Trinadapi Sunichena Tarorapi Sahishnana. He said this is the hallmark of a sannyasi. That means to give up physical possessions is easy, but Real sannyas means to give up that ego, that ahankar. So real sannyas is naham viprnacha narapati napi vaishyana shudra. Lord Chaitanya never identified himself with a particular varna or ashram. He said, I am not a brahmana, I am not a kshatriya. Although you may be in that duty in the network of the society, but I am simply gopir bhartur padakamalayor das dasanu das. He aspired to be the servant of the servant of the servant. And even our acharyas like Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur, he exhibited humility to an extreme degree. Even when his disciples, they would offer respects to him, he would return by saying, dasosmi, I am servant. He was in the mood of servant of servant. Somebody gave him a message that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur, some devotee wants to meet you, newcomer. So Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur would ask, what is his identity? How does he identify himself? So they asked and he said, I am a servant of Krishna. I am a servant of God. So Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur said, sorry, I have no time for you. But then later some other person came and he was asked, what is your identity? He said, I am a servant of the Vaishnavas. So Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur said, yes, please let him come in. So much he emphasized this principle of being humble. That is real sannyas. Being very humble, respectful, and giving all respects to others and not expecting respect in return. So Prabhupada writes in the last line, by engaging in the service of the Lord, one's life will be successful. See, if we can dedicate our life in this consciousness, then Ante Narayana Smriti. In the last moment, we can chant the holy name, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So actually, because we are, this calamity is certainly disastrous, we pray that all the world becomes again like a normal place. But at the same time, while we are in this situation, we can helplessly take shelter of the holy name more and more, because life is very short. Actually, the real fear is not just the coronavirus. That is one part of the fear. Prabhupada writes, the real fear is janma mrityu jara vyadhi. Even if the situation changes, the birth, death, old age disease will persist. Once Srila Japatak Swami Maharaj wrote a letter to Prabhupada and he asked his permission to study Bengali. So Prabhupada replied, yes, you can study Bengali, but in my opinion, if you have more time, then you should chant Hare Krishna more and more, because death can come any time, and before death comes, before we exit from the platform, Prabhupada used this word, before we exit from the present platform, we have to achieve perfection. So same teaching we can also imbibe while we are in this situation, whatever duties we can do with the limitations of the structure, but certainly we can intensify our chanting of the holy name, intensify our absorption in Prabhupada's messages, and intensify in praying. Praying is also a very important part of devotional service. Praying to Krishna, begging Krishna, please give me pure bhakti. Na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim, kavitam va jagadishya kambe. Mama janmani, janmani, ishvare bhavatad bhakti rahituki. My Lord, I do not want wealth or position or prestige. I just want to serve you. I would like to end with the small prayer of Vasudev Datta Thakur, one of my favorite prayers. When Lord Chaitanya asked Vasudev Datta, I was fulfilling the desire of all the devotees, what do you want? So Vasudev Datta Thakur said, my Lord, it pains my heart to see the suffering of all living beings. It's not that devotee is careless. When we hear about the so many deaths taking place, especially in United States, Italy and Spain, India also is increasing by some or other, by Krishna's mercy, still under control. We certainly feel painful. But then he said, I pray, Vasudev Thakur said, that let all living entities, irrespective of their karma, they may all go back home, back to Godhead. They may all be delivered to your lotus feet. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so pleased, he embraced Vasudev Datta Thakur and he said, do not worry, your desire will be fulfilled. So, and he said, but we cannot imitate Vasudev Datta Thakur, but to our capacity we can pray to Krishna for his causeless mercy on us and on all living beings. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. I'll request Mataji for some comments. Any other devotee may like to add or any corrections or... Yes, Prabhu. How he is a devotee of Krishna and Krishna also.
Yeah.
I'll request Mataji, would you like to enlighten? Some opportunity we can hear. Can give the mic to Mataji. Hare Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna and also a devotee. Sometimes he would, only in Mahaprakash Lila he accepted his Supreme Lord, nay? Otherwise he was always in the mood of devotee. So he is simultaneously devotee and that. Is that okay,
ma'am?
Prabhuji is asking how a common man can understand. He should take shelter of some devotee like you and then he can understand. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki jai.